I have a book we just launched, which is Faith Made Millionaire. It's got nothing to do with, a lot of people think it's about religion. It's about following your faith as an entrepreneur. And so I love your perspective on that. And we have conversations about your stuff all the time. I'm sure you can imagine.
Absolutely. And it's like, I do believe we have a duty to God and duty to the universe to be our best version of ourselves. And that's going to involve money, right? I mean, what it's got to. So our enemies will always try and paint us as bad or try and say that we are somehow negative for trying to acquire wealth. But when your enemies are rich, it's good to have some money yourself. You don't want to, you know, it's hard to fight a war with nothing. You can't be poor.
That's it, man. You can't be bringing plastic knives to a gunfight. You know?
You nailed it.
So what are your misconceptions when it comes to the subject matter of money or adding faith and money? Because most times this is a taboo subject that a lot of churches and a lot of faith-based groups don't want to talk about. They don't want to talk about relationships. They don't want to talk about politics. And they definitely don't want to talk about money, which is such an important topic today. The enemy has confused everybody that the church or God's people should not talk about it. So what is your context when it comes to stereotypes, myths, and misconception when it comes to faith and money? Which, by the way, chapter one of Faith Made Millionaire, which officially now is a number one bestseller on Amazon in multiple categories. Chapter one is destroying and demystifying myths and lies that many of you have had with faith and money. So therefore, you can go out there, play some financial offense, stop hiding behind God as an excuse, get the frickin' work, make a difference in our community, rise above this interest rate hike situation, rise above this pending recession that's, everybody feels that's already a recession right now. Technically we are, but nobody in the government has called it. When the winds of life come blowing by, you've got a financial weapon on your side. So stop with the excuses.